Namaste everyone. In today's video, we're going to focus on Muni Patanjali's Yoga Sutra 2.20. Now in this Yoga Sutra, Muni Patanjali is helping us to understand the concept of the drashta much better. He's going one step further in explaining how the drashta is different from chitta and what exactly are these two concepts. So let's look at the sutra, start breaking it up word by word and understand it even better. The sutra itself goes, drashta drishi matraha shuddhopi pratyayanupashyah. Let's hear that one more time just to understand it a little better. The sutra is, drashta drishi matraha shuddhopi pratyayanupashyah. Alright, so this is the Sutra 2.20. Now we're going to start breaking it up word by word to understand what the words stand for and what the Sutra means. So here the first word itself that we have is the word drashta. Now drashta here refers to a witness, a seer, an observing principle. The second word here is drishi, which essentially refers to the potential of seeing something, the ability to see something deeply. And the next word here is matra, which means merely or just as, the matra, the mere thing. Then comes shuddha. Now shuddha is a very common Hindi word as well, and it refers to purification or the complete sort of untaintedness of something, but it refers to the purification process or something that is pure. And then coming to api. Api is saying yet or although, and then it kind of continues what it's explaining. The next word here is pratyaya, in the compound word towards the end where we have pratyaya, and this is talking about the experience that the chitta has or the content that the chitta understands. Coming to the next word, we have anu, and anu is a very sort of like a word that kind of helps to conjoin a few concepts together, and it's talking about via or through something. And the final word here is pashya, and pashya means one who has seen or one who has perceived something. So now what is the sutra trying to tell us overall? So overall, the sutra is saying that yes, we have the drashta, which has the ability to just observe or witness. However, even though it's observing and witnessing in its essence, it does that, or we kind of mistake it to be doing that, through the lens of the chitta or through the perception power of the chitta. Now let's take a moment and really understand this concept a little bit better. So, in most cases, we kind of get confused between what is the chitta, what is the mind, and what is the drashta, what is the witness principle. So, this sutra helps to clarify that entire confusion for us. Muni Patanjali is explaining that essentially, when we have a stimulus presented before us, a bunch of different processes take place. And these processes kind of determine how each of our apparatus is going to comprehend the stimulus. So let's understand it this way. So the minute we have a stimulus in front of us, let's assume that we're looking at a source of light. So this light is now entering and we're comprehending it through our eyes. That message is going through our nervous system, reaching the brain. Through that, we're creating a perception of it in our minds. And this is what we understand even biologically, that all of these things are happening. Now, when you start going beyond the mind, you reach a place of chitta, which doesn't have an equivalent word in the English language. So we still talk about consciousness principle or chitta. And then when you go beyond that, beyond the perception of the chitta, is when you actually reach the purusha, or the entity that is simply observing but is not cognizing the stimulus. All right, so a few psychology terms here as well. It's really important to understand this, because we usually mistake the purusha to be the one that is creating the perceptions. We think the purusha, the witness, is observing as well as comprehending and creating a bunch of reactions, but that's not the case. The bunch of reactions is happening by the chitta, the perceiver, the one that is actually taking in a piece of information and reacting to it, whereas the Purusha is just merely observing. He's just there. It isn't reacting, it isn't doing anything about it, it's just watching, it's just a witness. And so that is the key difference. And a better example of this that is provided in the book is that you really want to think about when you are just engrossed in an activity and there's so many things happening around you, but you can't remember them, right? Like if you're engrossed in an activity and somebody over there is saying something, the sound might fall on your ears, but you don't remember it because it did not reach the chitta stage, you did not perceive it, it just fell on deaf ears. Quite literally. So that is essentially what is happening. But going one step even further, let's think about it this way. When we have the flight or fight response activated in our systems, it's our mind-body complex and it's the chitta which is doing that. It's perceiving a threat and it's reacting to it either through sweating, through running away, through wanting to scream. But while all this is happening, there is still a deeper entity within us which is not reacting, which is simply observing, which is literally like just watching what is happening. And that is such a deep concept. It's so hard to reach that because we're so caught up in the reactions of the chitta and the mind that even thinking about something within us which is just observing is really hard to do because of the radio and the noise that surrounds us in the chitta sphere itself. So therefore, this is a little bit challenging. It's a bit tricky to understand the difference between chitta and purusha. But once you realize that chitta is the one who perceives and cognizes, this is the one that does the reactions, then you will know that, okay, this is the person that's active, that's part of the prakritic realm, that's doing its thing, whereas the purusha is just taking a back seat and watching. It's like watching a movie. You're just looking at it. You're not getting involved in it. You're not saying that, let me go inside the movie and do something. You're just there, calm, cool, and collected. And so that is what the Purusha is all about. Why are we studying this? Because we're trying to understand the witness principle a little bit better so that in our meditation practice, we can actually see and experience this Purusha principle. And we're not limited to or we're not restricted by our understanding of just the chitta. We are able to go beyond it into a space where we are actually looking at the witness and we're experiencing a little bit of that witness principle which we don't normally experience in our daily lives. So that is what the Sutra 2.20 is all about. I hope this has been useful and helpful for you. I look forward to seeing you now in the next video. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Leave your comments in the comment section below. We love hearing from you. And if you'd like to interact with us, please do join our classes. We have philosophy as well as practical yoga classes. And you'll find the information in the links which are in the description. So I look forward to seeing you either in the next video or in our next class. Until then, take care and we'll see you really soon. Namaste.